Welcome to my channel. Myself Dr. Mohan Kalaskar from R.C. Patel Institute of Pharmaceutical Education and Research. Today we are going to discuss the ergot life cycle. So before starting an actual discussion, you can subscribe my channel to get a notification of the newly added video. You can again click on bell icon so that you can get a message of my newly added videos. So today we are going to start with an ergot. So ergot, you might be knowing it. This is an alkaloid containing material, and this is an only example from lower animal, that is from fungi. The only one fungi containing alkaloid is nothing but an ergot. So the ergot is very badly popular in mid time in the Europe because of its endemic spread of the certain effects of ergot. So that effects are known as the convulsive ergotism and gangrenic ergotism. So these ergot particularly contain a substance which having the psychotic effect, that is nothing but a lysergic acid derivatives. And this lysergic acid derivatives is responsible for convulsive ergotism. The convulsive ergotism is nothing but I put in picture over here. So in convulsive ergotism, the person who is taking or who is accidentally get an ergot, that produces some symptoms like body pain, trembling, shaking, wrecky neck, twisting of the neck, confusion, delirium, delusion. So that is something. The body posture is like this. This lady has been doing some body posture, as well as the twisting of the hand and as well as legs. So all these that time is considered to be curse of the god, and it is because of that it happens. So later on there are another effect. It was been found for the ergot is gangrenic ergotism. Gangrenic ergotism is because of the one of the constituent which having a peripheral vasoconstrictor effect. Okay, so that gangrenic ergotism is where the those who are taking the contaminated floor and this lead to the restricted blood supply to the extremities, and these extremities start to fall off. So this is what the gangrenic ergotism historically evidence is because of the ergot. Now we will see the some of the pharmacognosy of the ergot. So the ergot is also known as an ergot. It is known to be an ergot because the ergot is meaning is, so the name was initially ergot, later on is converted into the ergot. It is known to be Saint Anthony fire because he is a Catholic saint who used to prepare and some balms with an aromatic plant and used to give the patients who having a convulsive ergotism. And convulsive ergotism and gangrenic ergotism, they produces a burning pain. This burning pain has been relieved by such balm, and that balm is known to be Saint Anthony fire balm, and by which it produce it is nothing but an ergot, and because of that the name has been given Saint Anthony fire, that particular ergot. So as I mentioned, this is a fungus. So it consists of the dried sclerotium of fungus. Sclerotium means what it is here. Sclerotium is nothing but a dormant fungus. The fungus which is not being ready to multiply as well as to contaminate. But whenever they get a favorable condition, they are ready to contaminate the another plant. So it is a dried sclerotium of the fungus, that is Claviceps purpurea, belong to family Claviceptiaceae. It is not grows as such. It requires a host plant. It grows on a host plant, that is ovary of the ray plant sickle cell, belong to family Poaceae. So this is nothing but an sclerotium of the fungus Claviceps purpurea growing on the ovary of a ray plant, that is sickle cell, belong to family Poaceae. So these are the some limits for major alkaloid, major active constituent, that is alkaloid. It should contain 0.15% of the total alkaloid calculated as an ergotoxin. As I mentioned in history, it is found in mid Europe and as well as some parts of Russia and some parts of India. So in India it has been cultivated in the area of Tamil Nadu, that is Kodaikanal. Now we will see the life cycle. So before going for the life cycle, we should know what are the conditions are there. Okay, so this is and how the ergot present on the ray plant. So this one of the grain has been replaced with the sclerotium, which is come out as a wing. So that is an ergot. And when they got in full development, they fall from the ray plant, and whenever they get in favorable condition, they produce in such kinds of growth that is called as a perithecia. So perithecia having a head. So I again enlarge here. This is a perithecia and this is a head of the perithecia. And this head of the perithecia contain an ascites. Ascites are nothing but a small pockets which contain the fibrous filaments. That is nothing but an ascospore. So this perithecia in their head of asci, they contain a filamentous fungi which are ready to contaminate the another plant. And that filamentous fungi is known as ascospore. So ascospore is the first step into the life cycle of ergot. So now we will see here. So these are the ascospore. I can draw on here. So this is a filamentous fungi which are ready to contaminate the ray plant. So this is an I try to draw the flowering condition of the ray plant. So this is on one ray flower. This is another ray flower. So these ascospore, they get settled at the ovary base of the ray plant. And they start to develop and they start their life cycle. So once they get settled, they start to produce certain enzymes and they used to secrete over there. These enzymes helps to build in pseudoparenchymatous cells which produces an hypostand between this filamentous fungi and the ovary. So enzymes are responsible for making an hypostand, connecting stand between the ovary and ascospore. And during this formation of filamentous strand, this produces on white tissues. The white tissues are nothing but an pseudoparenchymatous tissues. Okay, and during this secretion of production of pseudoparenchymatous tissue, they secrete some sugary solution. This is in fourth stage. So that sugary solutions is known as honeydew. So here you will find they produce an hypostand. They start to accumulate in pseudoparenchymatous cells and slowly pseudoparenchymatous cell get increased. The amount of the pseudoparenchymatous cell increase and the pseudoparenchymatous cell start to secrete a certain sugary solution is known as honeydew. And these sugary solution, during the secretion of sugary solution, they start to produce another spore which is rounded in, that is not in filamentous, this is a rounded, that spores are known as canidiospores. So these spores are known as canidiospores and these spores are also responsible for the doing an infection on the another ray plant. So these sugary solution, they attract the insect and this sugary solution contain a spore that is a canidiospore, and from here also the another life cycle of the ergot is started. So this 1 to 4, that is from filamentous fungus to the rounded fungus spore, this stage are known as 1 to 4 is syphiacal stage. It is also known as canidiospore stage because here the another type of spores are produced. In the 5 stage, after the honeydew cease off, the secretion is stopped to secrete over there and they develop an pseudoparenchymatous cell, and this development of in the pseudoparenchymatous cell led to the detachment of ovary. So ovary gets shed off, okay, and these pseudoparenchymatous cell, they get an food material from the plant and they start to develop their own, and later on after few days they start to come out as an wing, okay, that is nothing but an ergot. Okay, so this wing is known as sclerotium. So I already mentioned sclerotium is nothing but a dormant stage of particular that fungi, and these sclerotium, when they got an fully developed, they get fall off on the ground, and when they get an favorable condition like air, moisture and temperature, they produce, as I shown in already, this they produce a strand that is nothing but an perithecia. They produce the perithecia having the head that is called as asci. The asci having an filamentous fungi, and these filamentous fungi are known as ascospore, and these ascospores are again ready to contaminate the another ray plant. So this life cycle can be divided into 3 steps basically. 1 to 4 step, that is they produce some canidiospores which are ready to contaminate the new plant. So that is known as syphiacal stage, also known as canidiospore stage. 5 to 7, so from here the pseudoparenchymatous cell develop into the fully grown dormant fungi, that is sclerotium. So that name is known, that stage 5 to 7 is known as sclerotium stage. And from 8 to 10, from where from dormant sclerotium convert into the active sclerotium, produces perithecia and then later to the ascospore, And as this ascospore again ready to contaminate the new plant, so this is known as ascospore stage. So I drawn here, this is in Perithecia, which is I mentioned here. So these Perithecia, they contain the one pocket like structure. So this is nothing but an ascospore, sorry, asci, and this asci containing the ascospores. So these ascospores are very minute filament structure. They are ready to contaminate. Now we will see how actually in the plant takes place. So this is what in first stage where the fully grown sclerotium is present. When they get in favorable condition, they will come out with an Perithecia asci. This asci is having this such kinds of pockets. They are having an ascospore. Then ascospore when get settled down at the base of the ovary and develop in pseudoparenchymatous cell. During that they produce a sugary solution. So you will be witness here. So this is a sugary solution that also contains a rounded spore, that is candidospore. This candidospore are also responsible for contaminant to produce an the ascospore, or if they further develop, they produce an ascospore. So this is an life cycle of ergot. So this is what the natural method, conventional method. But later on, the Dr. Abe from Japan has been developed the fermentation technology in which they successfully make out this strain that is Clavicis pushpalli, which has been grown on the artificial nutrient broth at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius and pH between 4.8 to 3, and this gives a maximum yield from 7 to 21 days. So this is having an advantage over the conventional method, because here the no climate constraints are there, so you can be develop an ergot alkylate at any season, because here the conditions are controlled. Rather, this as I mentioned here, the ergot contain ergotoxin, while this Clavicis pushpalli, they secrete another alkaloid or lysergic acid derivative, that is a clavin. So clavin is a lysergic acid derivative, this is a lysergic acid. So here at this position there is an OH, rather in lysergic acid it doesn't have an OH over here, and thus it produces the lysergic acid derivative. From the lysergic acid derivative, ergometrine or ergotamine can be semi synthesized, and thus this is an artificial method. Thank you for patient listening. Thank you.